national nightmare 25 years ago, Hurricane Lewis roared over the Lesser Antilles, bringing destruction over a 48-hour period to Antigua and Barbuda and surrounding islands. The day before it reached the Antilles, its winds reached a maximum of 140 miles per hour and remained at that peak value over the next 2 days. The destruction was immense. Churches, homes, businesses, schools, all suffering the same fate. Those who experienced the onslaught spoke about it in the aftermath.
This galvanized was flying around like paper, so it was very difficult. I don't know, it had to be the grace of God that took us down to this small house here.
I was frightened when the house blew away and my father couldn't find my sister, and I was crying too.
The storm was still on, galvanized was flying like mad, and you know, everything was just thrown about the place, and the wind was like maybe 140, 50 miles an hour, so, you know, even at that time, you know, but me feel helpless.
Some people came together, lending a helping hand to get their neighbors, family members, and friends back on their feet in a difficult time for everyone. The debris from homes and utility poles lined the streets. Those stranded on the island flocked the V.C. Byrd International Airport when it was clear to reopen, while holidaymakers who had visited for relaxing vacations ran out of options. While it was hard work to rebuild, the people of Antigua and Barbuda did what was necessary to get back on their feet. They toiled, and when the waters receded, they worked some more. 25 years later, the country continues to face peril from even stronger storms, even more crucial for everyone to embrace climate resilience. Terry Andrew, ABS News.